Bam! Mr. True, in this calculus lesson, we are going to take a quick look at the convergence or divergence of a P-series. We're going to be introduced to what a P-series is. We're going to use the integral test, which we just learned, to figure out if the P-series from n going to 1 to infinity of 1 over n, basically use the integral test to prove whether or not the harmonic series, which will be introduced here in a second, either converges or diverges, and then go through two last examples of just applying the rules of the P-series. So it's going to go very, very quickly. A P-series is a series in the format of 1 over n raised to some p power, some constant power of p. And that is going to be as you let, you know, n start at 1 and go to infinity, we have 1 over 1 to the p power, plus 1 over 2 to the p power, plus 1 over 3 to the p power, so on and so on and so on, with the idea of a series being, you know, going on forever. And this p series, this series here, is going to converge if p is greater than 1, and it's going to diverge if p is greater than 0 or less than or equal to 1. And by the way, mentioning the fact that our power could be a constant value of 1, means that if p is equal to 1, we have the series of 1 over n, and expanding that out is 1 over 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4, so on and so on and so on, which is called the harmonic series. It has a nice relationship with music. Okay, so we're going to use the integral test to determine the convergence or divergence of this p series, of the harmonic series. And we're not going to waste our time doing the integral test if we can show with just the nth term test that this series diverges. In other words, we're going to take a little minute here and we're going to find the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n, which is going to be 1 over n. Well, that's 1 over infinity, which is equal to 0. So if the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n, if that's not equal to 0, you're guaranteed the series diverges and you can just stop the problem right there. If the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n is equal to 0, that opens the door to the possibility of the series converging. It does not, however, guarantee it. And this is a nice, well, when we get done, keep this in mind, how we found the limit as n went to infinity of a sub n, and it came out to be 0. Kind of like, yeah, you're adding by terms that are going to approach 0. So it seems like you're effectively at some point adding by 0. So it would kind of approximately 0. So it would kind of make sense that this is going to converge. But we have it right here. If p is equal to 1 or less than 1, this actually will not converge. So let's see, you know, basically if that's true. If we're going to use the integral test to test whether or not the series converges or diverges, we need to make sure that we meet the three requirements of the integral test, which is to first, if we're going to, you know, work out some kind of integral, we need a continuous function. So we're going to have, or let f of x equal 1 over x. Sweet. Okay, well now we have this function. Is f positive? Well, yes, if, you know, sometimes this function 1 over x would give negative values, but if we're concerned about letting this function represent this a sub n term, and have a function which agrees with the sequence everywhere that we have a positive integer in the domain, then really we care about what's happening on the positive side, you know, basically where x is greater than or equal to 1. This is continuous, really, you could talk about x is greater than or equal to 0. So this is always going to be positive for those types of values. Is it continuous? Well, this function's undefined at 0, but again, it's continuous for where we're comparing this or using this function to represent or agree with the sequence a sub n is equal to 1 over n. So it's going to be continuous for all x values greater than 0, and really we care about those x values greater than or equal to 1. Is it decreasing? So we got the positive taken care of, we have the continuous taken care of. Is f of x decreasing? Well, let's look at the derivative. So we have this is equal to x to the negative 1 power, so f prime of x is equal to, bring in the power down, negative 1x, reduce that power by 1, we have negative 1 over x to the negative 2 power, which means the first derivative is equal to negative 1 over x squared. Well, yeah, if you take a number and you square it, the denominator is always going to be positive, and the numerator, of course, being negative 1 is a constant negative value. This derivative is always going to be negative. Thus, f of x is a decreasing function. So f prime of x is less than 0 for x greater than or equal to 1. So we meet the requirements, the conditions, to apply the integral test. So we're going to look at the definite integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x dx. Awesome. Since we've met the conditions for using the integral test, if this integral diverges, like if we get an answer of infinity or negative infinity, then this series diverges. If this integral converges, then this series converges. I talked about the relationship between these two in the beginning of my lesson involving or introducing the integral test for convergence and divergence of series. I'll put a link to that in the description. At any rate, the integral of the of 1 over x, or x to the negative 1 power, is going to be the natural log. So we have the natural log, absolute value of x, which really is redundant here because we're just looking at lower and upper limits, which are positive, so we'll just go ahead and drop that. We get the natural log of infinity minus the natural log of 1. Natural log of 1 is equal to 0, and the natural log of infinity is infinity. So this is going to diverge, giving us an answer of infinity. So since the first derivative, since the integral test shows that we have divergence for that definite integral, then therefore this given series diverges as well. So it's certainly not a proof of the rules that we have here for the convergence or divergence rules for P series, but at least we've done an example showing when P is equal to 1, that showing that the harmonic series is a divergent P series. Let's get on to two last examples and finish this lesson up. Alrighty, so we are going to stumble on the paper shredder, and we're going to determine the convergence or divergence of the P series. Now, here we just have a series of additions going on. It's a series of additions. We're adding for infinity. We don't have a sigma notation here. That means we don't have an a sub n, and we don't really know what type of series this is. But looking at the n values of 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, well, clearly it kind of seems like the numerators are staying a constant value of 1, the denominator has a cube root in it, and whatever n is, that value keeps showing up in the denominator. So it would appear that a sub n is 1 over, let's see here, these are all matching, so 1 over n, we have a cube root of, and then these match as well. So it appears that we have 1 over n times the cube root of n, which means that our series notation will be the summation from n starting at 1 and going to infinity of 1 over, again, n times the cube root of n. Well, that does not look like a P series. It's not 1 over n to some power, but it's not hard to make that happen. We have the summation from n going to 1 to infinity of 1 over n times n to the, now this is power over root, so n to the 1/3. When you multiply like bases, you add the exponents. And so we have the summation from infinity, or from 1 going to infinity, of 1 over 1 plus 4/3, of course, is 4/3. Oh, okay, so now we have it in exactly that format of 1 over n to the p. And so this is a P series. This is a P series with P equaling 4/3. Well, 4/3 is greater than 1. So therefore, the given series, what? If P is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1, it diverges. If P is greater than 1, the given series, the given P series, converges. All right, one last example. If you were trying to do these examples before I went over them, maybe you had the same pause that I did, because my intention was to take this a sub n term and split it up and talk about how we have, well, you're going to hear that discussion in a second. And I realized I'm about to split this up into two summation symbols. This is really just a copier. I don't know why I included it really in the lesson, but other than maybe just a little bit of a learning experience. If you have two terms in the denominator, you are not going to just separate that fraction into two separate fractions. It would work if that was in the numerator. This is a copy error from my notes when I was getting them on the board. My apologies. It should be 1 over n to the third plus 1 over n to the fourth. Okay, let's try this again. So we have the series of 1 over, well, n to the third plus 1 over n to the fourth. And, you know, does this converge or diverge? It seems like I have a p-series, a couple of p-series, in my a sub n, my nth term expression, my a sub n expression, that's not exactly the same kind of format that we needed or that we were given in our rules for determining the convergence or divergence of p-series. Well, that's simple enough. We just pull it apart. So we give each of these terms their own summation symbol just to get this to this problem to exactly match those rules that we were given, or the p-series rules. Now, great. We have a p-series exactly in that same format that we were given, with a p which is equal to 3. That means that 3 is greater than 1, so therefore this term, this series converges. With the same idea, here we have a p-series and so we have a p-series with a p-value of 4. 4 is greater than 1, so that p-series converges. So individually we have two series which converge, and now we have a series of the sum of those two nth terms, which means that that also converges. So since both of these converge, since both terms in this nth term, both of these p-series converge, the entire or the given series converges. As well. And that is the end of my last example. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Bam! Go do your homework.